want you to notice what God did on the days of creation to further highlight God's concern for structure and order. The part of the beauty of his creation. The first 3 days of creation, God gave the world form. And the next 3 days show us God filling the world, bringing fullness to emptiness. So there's a correspondence between days 1 and 4, 2 and 5, and 3 and 6. What I mean? Notice that in day 1, what is without form, God starts to give form to. What does he do in day 1? He created light with darkness. Light is called day. Darkness is called night. And then you'll notice in day 4 that God created lights for the day and the night. He's filling it, so to speak, to divide the night and the day, to rule the day and the night, for signs and seasons, for days and years. God is the one who has shown to us, look, I'm concerned about this thing called the passing of time, which he's not affected by, but he's given it for us, for signs and seasons, for days and years. Notice in day 2, he created space between the waters above and below. It's called the firmament or expanse. Ask me what it is. I don't know. I don't know. It's a space. It's an expanse, some translations, a canopy. And the description that we get is that there's waters below covering the earth, and there's waters above, and the space in between, the firmament, is sort of like what man goes outside and looks up. That's what he saw. And then we see that there's stars in that firmament, so where are they at? We read later in Genesis, at the flood, that there's a breaking up of waters on the earth and over the earth, and some suggest that maybe that firmament is what has given way to the waters that flooded the earth from above as well as from below. They're saying that God has created a place inhabitable for human beings, and then what he does when he fills that void, that form rather, where there's no form, he fills it with this expanse and these waters. What does he do on day 5? And he does this. He creates creatures for the water that's below and for the air. Abundance of creatures for the water, including great sea creatures and birds to fly above the earth. And then you remember what he does on day 3. He created the fertile earth, that is dry land with grass, herbs, and fruit trees. And then on day 6, he creates creatures for that earth, living creatures. Cattle, creeping things, beast, man, humanity, male and female in his image. Do you see what God is doing here? That he takes these 6 days to take what was without form and void, darkness. Remember we said the Spirit of God, it says there, verse 2, is hovering over the face of the deep. So even in that chaos, there's this picture. God is in control. And then that God who's in control shows the enormity of his creative power in speaking into existence something that will not only bring without form to form, but take what is there, a void, and fill it. You can see how the Lord puts all things in their place. And after he makes a place for them, and remember, he is making the place out of nothing, and then out of nothing, creating things to fill that place. What an incredible God. What power.